I'm very happy to be here today with you all. And as some of you may know, about 5 months ago, I had a liver transplant. So I now have the liver of a mid-20s person who died in a car crash and was generous enough to donate their organs. And I wouldn't be here without such generosity. So I hope all of us can be as generous and elect to become organ donors. I'd like to take a moment and thank everybody in the Apple community for the heartfelt support I got, too. It really meant a lot. And I'd also like to especially thank Tim Cook and the entire executive team of Apple. They really rose to the occasion and ran the company very ably in that difficult period. So thank you, guys. Let's give them a round of applause. So, I'm vertical, I'm back at Apple, loving every day of it, and I'm getting to work with our incredibly talented teams to come up with some great new products for you all in the future. So it's wonderful. Thank you. So today, we get to talk about music. Before we do, I'd like to say, number one, I'm going to have Phil Schiller join me for part of the presentation, as well as Jeff Robbins, our VP of iTunes Engineering. And before we dive into music, I'd like to talk for a minute about the iPhone. It's thrilling to report to you today that in a little over 2 years, we have sold 30 million iPhones. And during the last year, one of the reasons for that has been the remarkable App Store. The App Store is just a little over a year old, and we have now over 75,000 apps in the App Store. And users have downloaded over 1.8 billion apps. And yeah, isn't that incredible? And that does not include updates. If it included updates, the number would be a few times more than that. 1.8 billion applications have been downloaded. Now, today we have something new for iPhone and iPod Touch owners. We are introducing iPhone OS 3.1. It's got a bunch of really nice features in it and a bunch of bug fixes as well. And I just want to highlight two new things today. The first one is our Genius technology. Our Genius technologies work really well for automatically making playlists from songs in your music library that go great together. We've applied that same technology now to apps in the App Store. Wouldn't it be great if the App Store could make recommendations of apps to you, just like Genius is making recommendations of songs? And that's what it does now. It automatically makes recommendations from the App Store based on the applications you own. And it's really nice. You turn it on your iPhone or iPod Touch, and we've added a third button here called Genius next to New and What's Hot, and it'll show you recommendations based on what you already own. It'll even tell you what it's basing it on. And this will only get better and better and better as we get larger databases of people, what they buy, what they like. The recommendations will get better and better, just like they have for music. The second thing we're adding today is ringtones. We're adding ringtones to the iTunes store. We have over 30,000 ringtones from all four major labels. They're going to be sold at a breakthrough price for ringtones of $1.29, free previews, one-click purchasing, and they're in the iTunes store. We've bumped podcasts over under more, and we've given that slot to ringtones, and you can just buy ringtones just like you can other music, and they show up right on your iPhone, and you can set them to be ring for any particular number or be your default ringtone. It's really easy. So those are just two of the features in 3.1. 3.1 is free for iPhone and iPod Touch customers with 3.0, and it's available today. It's a free download from iTunes, so go check it out. It's really nice. So let's move on to music. Well, to start with, let's start with iTunes. We all love iTunes, use it every day. So do people around the world. iTunes is now in 23 different countries. We just opened Mexico a few weeks ago. And iTunes is the number one music retailer in the world now. We've sold over 8.5 billion songs, but a statistic that's even more amazing to me is we've recently crossed over 100 million accounts on iTunes, and all with credit cards, all with one-click purchasing. So that makes iTunes one of the largest stores on the web, 100 million accounts. So today we're introducing something really great, and that's iTunes 9, the next major release of iTunes. And this is what iTunes has looked like to date. And this is what iTunes 9 looks like. We've cleaned it up quite a bit, made it much easier to navigate around. And you'll see it in just a few minutes. But I want to cover a few features of iTunes 9. First of all is Genius Mixes. We're going to be applying Genius to yet another area. Now, when we first introduced Genius, it's gotten a great response. iTunes Genius is pure genius. And people have submitted now over 27 million libraries. And each has been about 2,000 songs, and so they've submitted over 54 billion songs that they have got in their libraries. And we've analyzed all of them, and the Genius database has just gotten smarter and smarter and smarter, and hopefully the recommendations have gotten better and better and better. And they've enabled all of us to make these Genius playlists. We pick a song from our library and automatically get a playlist of other songs in our library that go great together with that song. Well, we're applying that same technology and that same database now to something new called Genius Mixes. And what Genius Mixes are is, imagine a genius DJ that plays endless mixes of songs from your iTunes library that go great together, almost like radio stations. And iTunes will make up to 12 of them based on the music you have in your library and this awesome Genius database. And you just click on one to start playing it, and you see the album that's playing in particular, but they'll go on and on and on playing songs that go well together from your library, and it's really quite something. It's like a great DJ or a great radio station, and we think you're really going to like this. So Genius Mixes. Next, improved syncing. When you want to sync stuff to your iPod Touch or your iPhone, we can make that even better, and we have. So as an example, when you're going to sync music now, you can say, I want to sync these playlists, but I also want all of the music by Bob Dylan. And I want, rock and roll genre, everything from rock and roll. And it'll automatically figure that all out and put the right music on your iPod or iPhone. It's really nice. Or you might be in Photos. And, of course, if you have a PC, you'll sync photos from your folder onto your iPod or iPhone. But if you're on a Mac, you can sync albums, but you can also have events and faces from iPhoto and say, well, I want to sync these albums, but I want Becky's birthday, and I want all the photos that have a Lee in them. And it'll automatically do the right thing. Same with movies. I want the latest three movies that I've bought or rented, but I always want Ratatouille. So it'll do the right thing. Maybe the most popular thing that we're adding in improves syncing, though, is a way to manage your applications on your iPod Touch and your iPhone. This is really wonderful and allows you to arrange your applications however you want really fast and then automatically change them on your iPod Touch or your iPhone. It's wonderful. So improve syncing. Next up is home sharing. Now today, you can stream music from other computers in your house. You can look at their library, you can look at the libraries of your kids, your spouse, and whoever, and stream music from those libraries and listen to it on your computer in your house. And it's really cool. But we can go much further than that. Because with the new home sharing, we're going to let you copy songs, movies, TV shows, etc. among up to 5 authorized computers in your house. And so when you turn home sharing on by typing in your name and password, you're going to still see all the other computers that you can share with in your house. You can click on that, and you'll see their contents. You can stream the contents, or you can select it and drag whatever you want right into your library, and it will copy it. And you now have a copy. Matter of fact, we make it even easier for you with this little control down here where you can see only stuff on another computer that's not in your library to make it easy to find what you want to copy over. And you can even set it up to do this automatically. So it's really nice. Next up is a redesigned store. The iTunes store is just much, much cleaner, much better navigation so you can get from anywhere to anywhere almost instantly. New artist pages that are very nice. New movie pages, new TV pages. It's just a much, much cleaner layout that I think you'll enjoy. And finally, something I really love, iTunes LP. You know, some of us here are old enough that we actually bought LPs. And it was great, because you not only got the music, but you got great photography, you got liner notes, you got essays. I mean, you know, who could forget some of these classic albums? And unfortunately, most of that stuff left us when we went to CDs, and then, of course, even more so when we went to digital music. And that shouldn't be the case. We can deliver amazingly rich content digitally, and that's what we're doing with iTunes LP. So you bought a great album in the past, you can get that content again with iTunes LP. So this is iTunes LP for American Beauty, an awesome Grateful Dead album. And it's got everything with it. It's got videos, it's got liner notes, it's got all sorts of stuff. So here's an example of some lyrics. Here's an example of a chronology of their albums that you can go into and all the songs. Here's a Bob Dylan album. Here's a Great Doors album. Norah Jones album. Pearl Jam. Dave Matthews Band. And the artists themselves can get involved with creating these things. We're giving all the tools to the labels and the artists so that they can bring their creativity directly to the listeners. And we think this is going to be really outstanding. These are just a few of the features in iTunes 9. And what I'd like to do now is invite Jeff Robin up to give us a demo. Jeff?
Thanks, Steve. Good morning. I'm really excited to be able to show you some of the great new features of iTunes 9. So let's get started. Here it is. So I'm going to begin by showing you one of my favorite features, which is the app organization. I'm going to connect my iPod Touch. And here it is shown up on the left. So when I click on applications, now you can see all of the applications that are on my iPod. You can see all the pages. I can just click on them. And if I want to rearrange them, I can just click on an app and drag it wherever I want it to go. It's really easy. If I want to put it onto another page, just drop it right there. I can move it around. I can even select more than one at a time and drag those and put them where I want them. And iTunes just lays it out for you automatically. On the list on the left, you can see all of the applications that are in my library. Here's one, Bejeweled 2. If I double-click on it, it'll take you right to it on your iPod. If you've got a lot of apps, this makes it really easy to find where things are. And you know, I've played a lot of Bejeweled lately. I'm going to just remove it from my iPod. Click, and it's gone. It's really easy. We've also added the ability to search. I'm going to look for Tetris. And if I want to add that to my iPod, I just drop it there. And you know, I play my games a lot. There are a lot of great games on the iPod and the iPhone. I'm going to put my games page up to the top. It's really easy to rearrange and organize all the applications right on your iPod. And when you're done, just click apply, and all those changes are made. It's that easy. So now I want to show you home sharing. So I've already set this up so that my wife's computer is turned on for home sharing. Now I just need to turn it on for mine. So I'm going to enter my iTunes account and password. Click Create Home Share. Home sharing's on, and you'll see that Laura's library shows up in the list on the left. I can just click on it. It loads her library, and I can see everything on there. Open the triangle, you'll see music, movies, TV shows, even apps. Everything on her library is available to me. And I can scroll through, and if I see a song I like, I can just play it. Just like regular streaming. But the one thing you can't do with regular streaming, select the tracks and drag it to your library. It's that easy to manage content within your home. If I go down here, you can see this pop-up for showing all the items or the items that aren't in my library. Now you can see just what's different between the other library and yours. And when I select the tracks and tell it to copy, you can see they just disappear from that list. Those songs have been copied into my library. And if you want to have it automatically sync new purchases, under Settings, just turn it on for the types of content you're interested in. And now iTunes, whenever a new song or movie, TV show, or app is purchased on that other library, it's going to automatically copy it into iTunes. It makes it really easy to manage the content within your home. So that's home sharing. So let's take a look at the new iTunes Store. This is what the new store looks like. It's a really clean look. All of the pages throughout the store have been redesigned in the style. One thing you'll notice right away is that there's this new navigation bar at the top. So I can easily go from anywhere in the store, any page, and go directly to music, movies, or TV shows. There's even a drop-down if I want to go right to a genre. I can just go right to rock, and it takes me there. On the top charts, we've made it even easier to preview what's there. I can just click this preview button. And when you found the song that you want, just click buy right from the chart. It's really easy. Here's all the new music that's available this week. And I can just easily slide through it. And when I see what I'm interested in, like this Kings of Leon album's pretty great, there's an I button right on the cover. And if I click it, you get a quick view of that album. And previewing, just as easy as with that top song chart. You know that I can use somebody. And when you're ready to buy, just click buy. You know, you may have noticed we've got these arrows next to all the buy buttons through the store. We've added some interesting new features here. I can gift the album. I can add to a wish list. You know, wish lists have been a huge request for the iTunes Store, and now we've got that with iTunes 9. And I can also share directly to Facebook or Twitter. a link to any of the content within the store. Let me show you how that works. It takes me right to my page. I can type a note, click share, and it'll be posted right on my wall. Really easy to post information about songs and albums that you're interested in right on Facebook. So those are just a few of the things that we have for you with the new iTunes 9 store. We think you're really going to love it. So Steve mentioned iTunes LP. Let's take a look. Here are five albums that I bought from the store. And these are some really great albums with some fantastic iTunes LP extras. Let me show you The Doors. It's a great interactive experience. It's got photos, videos, memorabilia, chronology, even liner notes. And if I go to the song list, you can see all the songs that are on the album. I can just play it. And of course, we've got the lyrics. And I can just flip through the songs. You know, the day destroys the night. When I see something I like this one's really great, I'm going to play it. The photos are amazing. You know that it would be untrue. If you're a Doors fan, this kind of extra material is simply priceless. Go full screen. It's even got some exclusive videos. These videos were recorded exclusively for this iTunes LP. Here's one from the keyboardist of The Doors.
Jim and I went to the film school at UCLA.
I'm going to go
UCLA.
To a
we became close
section
friends.
I really think is cool here.
At that point, I said, well, this is it, man. We've got to get a band together, and let's get a band together. And he said, Ray, that's exactly what I had in mind. I said, man, cool. Except, what do we call the band? And he said, The Doors. And I said, the what? The Doors? That's like the most ridiculous. Oh, wait a minute. You mean like the doors in your mind? Aldous Huxley's book, The Doors of Perception. He said, exactly.
There's some great extras on these iTunes LP. Let me show you one more. This one's from Dave Matthews Band. They can be so beautiful. Let me explore the songs. I can just flip through. You know, the artwork for this LP was drawn by Dave Matthews himself. The handwriting is even based on his own, or the font is even based on his own handwriting. I can play the track and just scroll through. You can see all the lyrics. Just like the Doors, there are exclusive videos here, all sorts of extra content. If you're a fan, this is a great way to rediscover music with albums. So I've one last thing I want to show you, and that's something that we're calling iTunes Extras. Just like we've got iTunes LP for music, we have iTunes Extras for movies. So here's one for WALL-E. It's got all sorts of extra features, exclusive features, bot files. You can just click around and discover it. There's some great video content.
The beautician bot's multiple grooming arms keep passengers tweezed, combed, clothed, shaved, and waxed to perfection. Its supportive voice chip provides...
It's even got a really nice chapter picker. You can flip through, find your favorite scene. Here's one I really like. Lots of great extras. It really makes that movie experience feel even that much more complete. So those are just some of the cool new features in iTunes 9. Look forward to having you play with it. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff. So again, some of the very cool features of iTunes 9. iTunes 9 is available today. It's a free download at apple.com. So that is iTunes. Now, it's the biggest release of iTunes in a long time. I think you're going to like it. So now let's move on to the iPod. And I'm going to ask Phil Schiller to come up and tell us about some new things happening in the world of iPods. Phil?
Thanks, Steve.
Good morning, everyone. If you haven't heard, the iPod has been a big hit. It's absolutely incredible what's happened. We've now sold over 220 million iPods to date and growing. And that makes it one of the most successful products in history. Of all products, it's incredible. Customers love the iPod. If you look at the latest market share data in the US, the iPod is now at 73.8% market share. It's unbelievable. The next biggest category, other. Other at 18%. Right after that, SanDisk just over 7%, and Microsoft pulling in the rear at just about 1%. It's unbelievable, and yet with this amazing market of over 220 million iPods, we continue to reach more and more people. In fact, our latest data shows that of all the iPods we sell today, just over 50% are to customers that are new to the iPod. It's their first iPod. We love it when we help new customers discover how great it is to have a great portable music playing device. The fastest growing of our iPod line is the iPod Touch. Our most innovative product. And it's incredible. The new iPod Touch is just beautiful with that great 3.5-inch multi-touch display. And I'm really proud to tell you that to date, we have now sold over 20 million iPod Touch. 20 million, yes. That's in addition to the 30 million iPhones that Steve talked about. Just remarkable, this amazing new technology is taking off so quickly. And it is such a great, beautiful device. But you might ask, why so quick, so many iPod Touches? Well, we have an idea. We think of three things that really set it apart from any other device that's come before. First, it's a great iPod. And of course, it needs to be. It's the iPod Touch. It is an amazing way to listen to your music. You just use the multi-touch display to flick through any songs you want to find or to discover a new album you want to listen to, and you just tap on it and play. It's an amazing music experience. It's also a great video experience. You can watch video podcasts, TV shows, movies, even new movies in iTunes that you can rent and put on your iPod Touch to watch on that beautiful 3.5-inch display, tap, and just enjoy your video. So it's incredible for listening to music and playing videos. It's also great for discovering new music, like this new Green Day album, because built into every iPod Touch is Wi-Fi and the iTunes Music Store. So now wherever you are, you get on Wi-Fi and you just start surfing and finding something new to listen to take with on a trip, whatever you want to do. It's incredible. It's also great for discovering music on your iPod Touch, because with thousands of songs, sometimes forget all the great content you have. And that's where Genius comes in. This Genius technology is just incredible for helping you find music you love and just enjoy this experience of listening to music on an iPod Touch. Of course, you can create playlists, as Steve talked about. You just tap a song and say, make a Genius playlist. And your iPod Touch will make a playlist out of that song and other songs you have that go great with it. You can just sit back and enjoy it. And now, with the new Genius Mixes, you can also do that on the iPod Touch as well. You don't even have to select a song. iTunes automatically creates mixes for you of the songs you have that go great together. So the iPod Touch is a great iPod. Customers have already started to figure out it's also something else. It's a great pocket computer. That's a really cool idea that built into every iPod Touch is Wi-Fi. So wherever you can get on Wi-Fi, you can get on the internet, which is great because the iPod Touch is the first great mobile browser. Safari. And with Safari, you can have a desktop-like experience. You can surf the web and portrait and landscape. Go to all of your favorite sites all on this great little pocket computer. Of course, it has great email as well. You can have rich HTML email. You can have attachments. You're never disconnected with an iPod Touch. You have access to all your contacts as well. You can enter them right on the iPod Touch, sync them back, or you can just sync them all from your PC or Mac automatically through iTunes. And of course, you can sync them wirelessly with MobileMe. And there are so many applications in the App Store to really make this a rich experience. Things you like to do on the desktop, you can do right on this amazing little computer. Things like Facebook. If you have a Facebook account and want to keep in touch with all your family and friends, it's really cool to do on an iPod Touch. Maybe you're a Twitter fan, and there are people you like to follow their tweets. Well, you can do that too. All this power in this little amazing computer, and it really fits in your pocket. Not everybody can say that. Not everybody's computer fits in their pocket, but ours really does. It's the iPod Touch. It's a great iPod. It's a great pocket computer. And you've probably noticed people starting to talk about one other thing. It's a great portable game player as well. This beautiful multi-touch display and accelerometer have allowed developers to create incredible new games on the iPod Touch. And people are starting to notice. For example, Business Week wrote, Apple could be on the cusp of claiming the crown as the world's leader in handheld gaming. And that's pretty big words. When you think about it, the companies that have come before us, Nintendo and Sony with devices like the PSP and the DS, when these things came out, they seemed so cool. But once you play a game on the iPod Touch, you know, they don't really stack up anymore. They don't have this amazing multi-touch user interface. Their games are kind of expensive. They don't even have anything like the App Store for finding great games and titles. And they certainly don't deliver a media experience like the iPod that's built into the iPod Touch. And when I say they're expensive, we're talking about $25, $30, $40 for a title. A lot of kids can't afford a lot of titles. When you give one of those, you're giving a need to spend a lot of money on those titles. But worse isn't the price, it's the buying experience. Having to go to a store and try to find a hot new title for one of those devices is not a lot of fun. The buying experience on an iPod Touch is incredible. It's truly breakthrough. Built into every iPod Touch is the App Store. You can find access to all of the 75,000 titles. It's just incredible. If you look just at the gaming and entertainment category alone, you're going to see a big difference. So I'm going to bring up a chart of the gaming and entertainment titles available on Sony PSP, Nintendo DS, and iPhone OS. And here's what it looks like. Sony PSP, 607 titles. Nintendo DS, 3680. iPhone OS, 21,178. It's absolutely incredible the amount of work developers are doing to bring amazing content to the iPod Touch and the iPhone. Now, if you haven't had a chance to play some of these amazing new games and titles yet, we've actually grabbed some video off of an iPod Touch to create something just to show you how cool these games have become. And let me play that for you now. Those games are just amazing. And every day we're seeing new titles come out that just blow our mind. And so we wanted to share a few of the things we've been seeing going on in development with some of the developers with you so you can see these things for the first time. So we're going to ask a few developers, our really good friends who are working hard on the software, to come on stage and show you a few things. First up, we're going to invite up Ubisoft. Now, Ubisoft, if you don't know, is a leader in the entertainment industry. And their hot title, Assassin's Creed, became the fastest new video game brand ever. And to tell us what's coming up next with Assassin's Creed is Ben Matz, producer of Assassin's Creed at Ubisoft. Ben?
All right. Wow, I'm really happy to be here, and let's jump right in. So, Apple has created a world-class gaming platform with the iPod Touch and the iPhone. And Ubisoft, as Phil is saying, is putting the finishing touches on one of this holiday season's hottest entertainment properties, Assassin's Creed 2. I'm here today to tell you about how we're bringing these two together. In Assassin's Creed 2, you play the hero Ezio, an Italian nobleman from a family of assassins who've been fighting against the Templars throughout history. Thanks to the ubiquity and the simple distribution of the iPod Touch and the iPhone, now tens of millions can know the thrill of being Ezio. Ubisoft is well known for the award-winning quality of its graphics and its animations, and as you can see behind me, this game is no exception. Assassin's Creed is all about visceral combat, brutal hand-to-hand, and wicked one-shot kills. Thanks to the power of these devices, we can put incredible diversity into the animations and the sound effects. So when you're fighting in this game, you're going to feel every blow. Assassin's Creed is also about exploration and about customization. Now, whether it be putting your own face on the wanted posters that appear on the walls throughout the game using your photo library, or uncovering a secret art cache where you can unlock an exclusive illustration to use as a wallpaper or to send to a friend, the iPod Touch and the iPhone let us bring you closer to the world of Ezio than ever before. And finally, Assassin's Creed is all about the flow of spectacular acrobatics through exotic and historic locations. The intuitive touch controls allow you to guide Ezio through these incredible free-running experiences, and it's an absolute breeze. Fans of Assassin's Creed can get in on the action from day one. We're bringing this title to market day and date with the other console versions, November 11th, combined with an exciting fan app and short films on iTunes that flesh out the backstory of Ezio and the Assassin's Creed universe. Clearly, the iPod Touch and the iPhone are the place to be for gamers and Assassin's fans alike this holiday season. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot, Phil. Okay.
That is so much fun. Next up, this is a really great story, Tapulous. Tapulous is a developer that was founded in January of 2008 with a specific focus to create games and titles for the iPhone and iPod Touch. They've had a super hit title in Tap Tap Revenge. It has over 10 million users today. And now they're working on something really creative and new, merging two different styles of games together, music and racing, into something unlike anything we've seen before, and it's really innovative. And to tell you what that is all about, I'd like to invite up their founder and CEO, Bart de Krem. Bart?
Thanks, Phil. Good morning. When we launched on the App Store a year ago, our crazy dream was to get to a million users in the first year. We hit that goal in just 3 weeks. Today, Tap Tap Revenge is one of the most popular games on the App Store, and an awesome 3.0 release is just around the corner. But today we're introducing Rhythm Ribbon, a completely new music game built especially for the iPhone and the iPod Touch. Rhythm Ribbon puts you in the role of the DJ. Now, this is a new kind of game, so let me set the stage. You'll be racing down a ribbon. You are the DJ, and your job is to follow the groove, or your rich sound will be stripped down to its basic drum beats. Let's give it a go, and we'll play to the biggest hit of the year.
People in the place, if you wanna get down.
That's Boom Boom Pow by the Black Eyed Peas. And Andrew is tilting his phone side to side to the beat to follow the groove and keep the ball on the green line. Now, along the way, you choose from remixes to your song by some of the biggest DJs on the planet. At the next intersection, we're going to cut a right for the Super Black mix, which is just a little deeper. There we go.
Here we go, satellite radio, y'all get
There are jumps and hoops that you catch by flicking your phone to layer on additional bonus sounds like these booms. Nice. All right, let's get the third one. Great. Now make sure you don't hit that side rail. Ouch. We just got dropped back to the bass beat. Andrew, get us back in the groove. All right, there we go. Now to stay in the game, you need to clear the checkpoint, and Andrew did it. Good job. There are tons of combinations of mixes and effects. So by the end of your level, you'll have created your own unique mix to a hot track. Then every time you play, you can make a new mix. After the game, you can share your mix with your friends and challenge them to beat you at your game. Rhythm Ribbon is launching in October, and the game will come with three Black Eyed Peas content bundles created especially for this game by will.i.am. We're delighted to announce that the first special level, which will be available for an app purchase, will be by Tiesto, who's been voted the number one DJ in the world 3 times over. Thank you, and rock on.
Next up, Gameloft. Gameloft is an amazing developer that's been with us on the App Store right from the very beginning. Today, they're shipping 35 gaming titles in the App Store. They've had some amazing hits, and they're working on some incredible new content for you to see. And they have now almost 20 million downloads, making them one of the biggest developers in the App Store. So to show you what they're working on next, I'd like to bring up Mark Hickey from Gameloft. Mark?
Thank you, Phil. Thanks. Good morning. I'm really excited to be able to give you all today a sneak preview of our latest project. It's a first-person shooter. It's called Nova, and it is awesome. In Nova, you play as a space marine, and your mission is to defend humanity against an alien attack. The single-player game ships with 12 levels, 5 powerful weapons, a wide range of alien enemies, and graphics that we think are the best that have ever been seen on the platform. So now, as you can see, we got our ship, it's landing on this alien world, and we're in a hostile environment here, so the first thing we're gonna do is pull out our arsenal and assault and equip the assault rifle so we're ready for any surprises. So we're getting attacked by these drone soldiers here. Our mission is to rendezvous with the Marine platoon that's waiting for us on the other side of this valley. Now, since we're facing some pretty heavy resistance here off the bat, we're gonna move forward a little more cautiously. Equip the sniper rifle, and now you can see there's this enemy patrolling further down the trail, so we're gonna zoom in on him, and once he's lined up in our sights, take the shot, headshot, nice shot. Cool, so now of course Nova also ships with media player integration, so now you can listen to your iPod music when you're out there fragging aliens. So that huge gun that you see on the screen is the plasma cannon. When you hold down the right fire button, it charges up and releases a huge blast. Now, over and above the single player game, Nova's gonna have fully featured multiplayer. We got over Wi-Fi and over Bluetooth. We're gonna have a bunch of cool iPhone 3.0 features like push notification to challenge your friends and voice chat. So we're really excited about Nova. We hope you guys are gonna love it, and you'll be able to get your hands on it when it ships a little later this year. Thank you very much.
I don't know about you, but if you've been in playing first-person shooters like I have for so long, and that's stuff I couldn't do on my personal computer on my desk not too long ago. Just incredible, now on an iPod Touch. Well, last up of our developers I'm going to invite on stage today, EA. I think they're such a tremendous force in the gaming industry, they don't need a lot of introduction, but they really are an amazing developer, and they've been a hit not only on all other platforms, but on the App Store as well. They've had 3 number one selling hit titles. And to show you the next title they're working on, which is sure to be another big number one hit, I'd like to bring up Travis Boatman. Travis is in charge of their studios for their mobile applications, and he's going to show you what's new. Travis?
Hi, everybody. So we're really excited to be back to talk about one of the world's largest video game franchises. This is a game that's been around for over 20 years, really remarkable. And it's coming for the very first time to the App Store, and that game is Madden NFL 10 from EA Sports.
Hey, I have to say, I'm really excited about this matchup today.
So a vital component of any Madden game is its NFL authenticity. And as you can see here, we have all 32 teams and all the players you'd expect to see in this product. For today's demonstration, we're going to be playing with our local boys, the San Francisco 49ers, going up against the Super Bowl champs, the Pittsburgh Steelers. You can also see, not only do we have all the teams and players, we also have the real stadiums like Candlestick Park rendered in the background. Now, while kickers don't spend a lot of time on the field, when they do, it's usually crucial to gameplay. So to that end, we designed a custom kicking interface for the iPod Touch. Joel's going to demonstrate that for you now by simply taking his finger and aiming anywhere he wants right on the screen. With a simple sweep up and down, he's going to kick that ball. You can see he's been practicing as he kicked that right into the end zone. Nice. We need to do that so we can get on defense. Now, in defense, you can see we have a deep NFL playbook with all the plays you'd expect to see on any given Sunday. So let's pick one of our favorite plays and get out there. Now, we don't need the D-pad to select our players. A great innovative feature of the iPod Touch is you can tap directly on the screen. So Joel's tapping on any defender he wants to take control right on the screen. Really intuitive. Take control he did. Good job.
Penalties and takeaways can really kill a team. Usually the team with the fewest mistakes out there will win the game.
Good advice, John. All right. So now we're going to pick a play that we saw this weekend in preseason, tight end flat. Ugh. So I don't like the look of this lineup against us. We probably have a mismatch here and a bad play. So we're going to use another innovative feature of the iPod Touch called Hot Routes. And what allows this or us to do is to take our finger and simply draw the play right on the screen any way we want. Super intuitive. And this gives us unparalleled control like never before. Really cool. So now Joel's going to again tap directly on the screen to access any of the open receivers and then hit the action control button to slow the action down so we can make this important play for you guys. Nice. So those are just a few of the features we've packed into this year's version of Madden NFL 10 available in the App Store today, just launched this morning. But that's not all. We also have more games come to the App Store, including Command & Conquer, NBA Live, and even Need for Speed Shift. Thanks, everybody.
Well, I hope you agree with us that the iPod Touch is not only a great iPod, a great portable computer, but it is an unbelievable gaming playing device. And you've just seen some of the hot new titles about to come out. It's just going to keep growing. In fact, when we think about the iPod Touch, it's kind of cool to think about it as really the most affordable gateway to the App Store. That App Store is packed with so much amazing software, not only all the games and entertainment titles you've seen, but just about anything you want, whether you want to get a title to read a book, or to create a piece of art, to follow your favorite stocks, or work on an education project. And there's something for everyone. There's an incredible category for medical professionals. There's an app for anything you want, whether you're a bird watcher or a latte sipper. There's something great for everyone in the App Store. And especially, as we're talking about the iPod Touch, over 20,000 titles for games and entertainment. It's the most affordable gateway at $229. And most importantly, of course, you don't need a subscription. Once you give it as a gift to a friend, they can just start playing. They don't have monthly fees, and then they can add and explore that amazing App Store. Now, we learned something really important a few years back in the iPod business. We had what at the time was our most affordable and best-selling music player, the iPod Mini. And the iPod Mini was selling for $249. We asked the engineering team to work really hard to get the cost down so we could bring it to market at $199. And when we did, something really incredible happened. The sales doubled. We learned something that day. $199 is a magic price point in the iPod market. With that price point, we can reach more customers. So that's just what we're going to do with the iPod Touch. The most important thing, give it to even more customers to get access to all this incredible software. So bring the iPod Touch down today to $199 for an 8-gigabyte iPod Touch. So let's bring up the prices of the iPod Touch lineup. We're going to bring that 8-gigabyte in at $199. In addition, at $299, we're going to double the memory to 32 gigabytes. And at $399, we're going to double it again to 64 gigabytes. Think about it, 64 gigabytes of flash memory in this amazing little pocket computer. It's just incredible. There's two other things about that 32 and 64 gigabyte versions of the iPod Touch I wanted to make sure you knew about. First, we've worked harder to make it even faster. It's already fast, but now up to 50% faster in most everything you do. And for gamers, they're going to appreciate that we've added the graphics power to bring on OpenGL ES version 2.0, and this is what the next generation games are going to be using to get even more realism in these incredible portable games. But the really important thing, and I can't overemphasize this, is the power of that price, $199, creating an even more affordable gateway to the App Store for our customers. And we're so excited about the incredible growth and amazing software on the iPod Touch that we've made it yet another ad to show all the world about how great an iPod Touch is. Our agency's created this really killer ad, and I'd like to run it for you now. So the iPod Touch is without question the funnest iPod ever. Next, the iPod Classic. The iPod Classic is a great device for customers who have a large music library and, for example, like to keep all of those songs plugged in their car stereo or at home with their home entertainment system. And today, we've got one thin version that's 120 gigabytes for $249. So what we're going to do today with the iPod Classic is up that capacity to 160 gigabytes, the same thin size, the same price, $249. 160 gigabytes allows those customers to store 40,000 songs. And believe it or not, we have customers with libraries that big. It's just incredible, and they appreciate the iPod Classic. All right, next, iPod Shuffle. The iPod Shuffle is an amazing device. It's literally the smallest music player in the world. It's got this great built-in clip, so you can clip it right on your clothing. And it's the easiest to use iPod as well. There's no controls directly on the device. The controls are on your headset. And it's really easy with just a single click to play, pause, volume up, volume down, next song, previous song. It's so easy, and customers have asked us to expand the range of options of headphones you can use with the iPod Shuffle. So we've worked with a number of headphone makers, and you're going to see a range of products now coming out that all have the integrated controller for the iPod Shuffle, in addition to an adapter that has the controller you can plug any headphone into. So the iPod Shuffle, it's the world's smallest music player. It's also the first music player that talks to you. We use voice over technology so that, for example, if you're using your iPod Shuffle and you want to know what's that song I'm listening to right now, it holds so many, well, you can just hold down that button and it'll tell you.
Know Your Enemy, Green Day.
Now, when we added that voiceover technology, it allowed us to do something else we couldn't do before in the Shuffle, which is we were able to now support multiple playlists so that you can have a different workout mix or a mix for whatever you want, and you can just hold down the button and change your mix.
Workout mix.
So voiceover gives us readings of what your song is, what your artist is, what playlist you want to listen to. It even gives you status information.
Battery full.
And this is really useful. If you use it, as many of our customers do, in active environments, running, at the gym, on a bike, you really appreciate the ability to control and change what you're listening to without ever having to look down at the device. So what's new with the iPod Shuffle? Well, today we're bringing out all new colors. Black, silver, pink, green, and blue. Five colors. In addition, we're making it even more affordable with a new model, $59 for 2 gigabytes in those five colors. That joins the 4 gigabyte model at $79, again, in those five colors. And those are all shipping today. So new price point, $59, $79, five colors each. We also wanted to make one more that we really think is beautiful. We call it the special edition. This is made out of polished stainless steel. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's $99 for a 4 gigabyte model. It'll be available on the store for the online store and the retail stores. Again, the special edition in stainless steel. So that's the new iPods. I'd like to turn it back to Steve.
So, new iTunes 9, new iPod lineup for the holidays. We're really glad to share this with all of you today. But we do have one more thing. And that is a video camera. You know, we've seen video explode in the last few years, nowhere more than on YouTube, which is serving up 1 billion video streams a day. And where are these streams coming from? They're coming from folks like us who are using these portable solid-state video cameras to take personal videos. And it's incredible. So here's one, very popular one. 4 gigabytes of memory, $149. And this market's really exploded. And we want to get in on this. So what are we going to do? Well, we're going to start off with 8 gigabyte unit, 8 gigabytes of memory. And we're going to lower the price from $149 to free. This is the new Apple, isn't it? So how are we going to do that? The way in which we're going to do that is we're going to build a video camera right into the new iPod Nano. On the back of every Nano is a video camera and a microphone integrated right in. And there's a speaker inside as well to listen to the music, to listen to the sound of your videos. So built into every iPod Nano is now an awesome video camera. And yet we've still retained its incredibly small size. And you realize how small when you compare this to other devices. Right? A fifth as thick, a tenth the volume. So you can take along your iPod Nano and always have your video camera with you, this tiny little package. So how good is it? Turns out it's great. Let me just show you a little bit of real video off it here.
All right, we call this a 3Z on 3Z. 1, 2, 3Z. Woo!
So you can watch your video right on the Nano over and over and over again. You can also sync it back to your computer, to your My Videos folder if you're on a PC, or right in to iPhoto if you're on a Mac. And with one click, you can send it to YouTube. And this is that same video, undoctored, on YouTube.
All right, we call this a 3Z on 3Z. 1, 2, 3Z.
So, pretty amazing to always have a video camera of that quality in your pocket, built right into your iPod Nano. Now, the iPod Nano is a pretty incredible device. It is the most popular music player in the world. We've sold over 100 million iPod Nanos. By far the most popular music player in the world. And it's a great music player. It's got CoverFlow built in. We're adding VoiceOver, the same as the iPod Shuffle. And we're adding some other really cool things too, like Genius Mixes. So you can make a Genius Mix, or actually it will automatically make Genius Mixes. Here's three of them, a jazz mix, a rock mix, a blues mix. Again, endless mixes of songs that go great together out of your music library, created with this giant database and the Genius technology. We've also built in for the first time an FM radio. So you've got a great FM radio built into your iPod Nano now. And we've built in a voice recorder app using the built-in microphone, as well as a pedometer. Right? So you can keep track of your steps, and you can even sync up on the web to Nike Plus for long-term goals like this. So, the new iPod Nano. Built-in video camera. It's got a larger 2.2-inch display, same great enclosure, built-in microphone and speaker, voiceover, FM radio, pedometer, a lot of great new stuff in the same beautiful design. And it comes in awesome colors this year. We finally figured out how to do colors that are just unimaginably beautiful. They're polished, anodized aluminum. And when you see them, it's hard to believe how stunning that they are. So, the iPod Nano, in all these great colors, comes in two models. An 8 gigabyte for $149, and a 16 gigabyte model for $179. And they're all available today. So we made kind of a cool ad that I'd love to show you now. So let's run the ad. Isn't that great? So, the new iPod Nano joins the iPod Shuffle, the iPod Classic, and the iPod Touch. And this is our lineup for this holiday season. And of course, we paid attention to the environmentals as well. All these iPods use arsenic-free glass. They're all BFR-free, mercury-free, polyvinyl chloride-free, and with their metal and glass designs, they're all highly recyclable. We pay a lot of attention to this. So, iPod plus iTunes. An incredible new release, iTunes 9, available today. And a great lineup, very strong lineup of iPods for the holiday season, again, available today. So, that's what we wanted to show you. We're really pleased that you came. And we've got a hands-on area where you can go get your hands on some of the stuff in person. Now, we've got great teams of people that work really hard to create these products for you. And one of the things that really drives us is, like you, we love music. And we never want to forget that. That's probably the primary reason we do this. And there's no better way to remind us all at events like this than by having a live performance. And we are really lucky today in that Nora Jones is going to join us for a live performance. Nora's released 3 albums to date, and they've sold 36 million copies. That is a ton. Highly successful. And an even more important measure is she's won 9 Grammy Awards. So, this is her new album. It's coming out this fall. And would you please welcome or join me in giving a warm welcome to Nora Jones.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
Thanks for being here.
This is the earliest I think I've ever played, but it's okay. Thanks. Thanks to Steve Jobs for having us, and really happy to see him doing well. And there's a lot of secret passageways back there, secret knocks. I feel like a burden has been lifted now that we're actually playing. No, just kidding. You know what I mean. I'm bad at secrets, so. So we're going to do a song from my new album that's going to come out in November. And we haven't really played this one that much. What's going on there? So, yeah. This is a song called Young Blood.
I'll pretend my heart's not on fire. Steal my true love's name, broke down subway in the city of spires. Tape your picture over here in the frame. We'll imagine we're sleeping revolver, shotgun wedding in a strange soho. Our chambers hold silver collars. Gun down werewolves wherever we go. Gun down werewolves wherever. Midnight phone calls, the back of a Mustang, crisp white pages torn right from the spine. Kiss my neck with a crooked, cracked fang. You always hoped one day you'd be mine. Through our fathers, our funeral pies, I'm not sure we were playing a game. Busted gasket in a field full of lions. No one noticed we set five bows aflame. No one noticed we set five bows aflame. Young bone, old ghost, go home. Band of gold, where the diamond implies you wrote letters. You never said I made promises. I'll always deny. Now I never know what the other meant. Watch us ticking, like a heartbeat gone berserk. Lost a chance to wind the key. Roosters are nothing but clucking clockwork. Our fears are only what we tell them to be. Our fears are only what we tell them to be. Drown the last of our matches. Burn the rest of each other. You were strongest when I ached for breath. Through the thick of smoke we'll finally smother.
Well, that's what we have for you today. Thank you for coming, and we'll see you soon.